Hey everybody, it's been a while since I stopped in to say hi in person, so hi, first of all. In this video, I just want to talk about Instagram TV. If you haven't heard, it recently launched and it's going to allow Instagram users to upload up to a 10-minute long video and then hour-long videos for some other accounts. This might be a platform that has an opportunity to actually compete with YouTube because Instagram is boasting just millions of users and it's considered like the hot way to engage with your audience right now. Specifically, what I'm going to talk about though is how this ties in with Adobe Character Animator. One of the things that I love about Character Animator is you can quickly make animations of characters that can be used for things like explainer videos or just like a fun way for you to quickly engage with your audience on a regular basis. So, I'm going to show you how to configure Adobe Character Animator to get a vertical video, because Instagram TV is all vertical like this. It's meant to be viewed on your phone in the app, and it's embracing the idea that a lot of people are watching videos on their phones now. So YouTube traditionally is like this, although you can upload vertical videos to YouTube and it will reformat the player in order to accept that. But natively, Instagram is only going to be accepting, or Instagram TV is only going to be accepting vertical videos. It will let you upload a horizontal video, but it's going to look terrible. It's going to be this tiny little image. Now, what's really neat about this, though, is if you have a full body character on the screen, and you can get that to fill up this phone really nicely, it's just going to be this cool, engaging, animated character on the viewer's screen. And I think that's just awesome. So I'm not going to talk anymore. Let's just jump into it. We should be able to blow through this in just a few minutes here. All right, hello again. I'm now in my little Adobe Character Animator box. So here we have the PewDiePie character. It's one of my first characters I made, actually. And we're going to go ahead and use him for this demo. Alright, so what we want to think about is HD video, for instance. Some of the common sizes, 1920 by 1080 is a pretty common size, and that's generally what I upload my YouTube videos as. So since we're going to be putting this on a phone, and this might be hard to see in this tiny little screen, we just want to flip that. Now fortunately, we can click here in our timeline. Just make sure you don't click on the character. And you'll see on the right hand side here, 1920 by 1080 is our current width and height. And I'm just going to go ahead and swap these. So I'll go ahead and type 1080 into the width and 1280 into the height. And now you see I have this nice more vertical sized screen here. Drag that into the center. And then I just want to select my character here, and I'm going to find the transform tab over here in the right. And I am just going to mess around with these position values a little bit until I get him framed up nice right here. Now he doesn't have a full body. As one of my first characters, I just kind of cheated. But this should still actually work out pretty nice here. So we're just going to go ahead and record some video and render this out and see what that looks like. My scene's all set up, and now it's just time to do a little bit of acting. All right, everybody, so at this point I've rendered out my video. I went ahead and used my normal YouTube settings. I think I used 1920 by 1080, just like the video I set up here in Adobe Character Animator, AAC audio. You can mess around with those settings. I don't really think that that's necessarily always what you're gonna want, or that you need something that HD. So play around with that and see what works for you. But I think this should turn out pretty good. So the next thing you're gonna need to do is get Instagram TV. Now the Instagram PC program or application will allow you to use your web camera to create video, and so there's probably potential for you to be able to get stuff on Instagram TV that way. But for the most part, everything happens through this phone here, right? So I do a little trick, and hopefully Instagram's not gonna like bust me for this or something, but I will take videos like this, and I usually keep them pretty short so it's not a huge file, and I email it to myself or put it in like a Dropbox or something, download it onto my phone. Now the thing you want to keep in mind when you're downloading that onto your phone is that Instagram is generally going to look in like specific places for the video files, and at least from my experience here, it only showed me like 4 locations in my albums. So you're going to make sure that you download that file to one of those locations or use some kind of file manager on your phone to move it into the right place. Alright, so once I email this to myself, I'll download it and then I'll go ahead and upload it. Now to do that, you're going to need the Instagram app, and you should have gotten an update if you have auto updates on that gave you the Instagram a TV button. Basically, it's going to look like a little TV in your Instagram app, or you can download the actual Instagram TV app, which is what I did here. And this is just going to give you a few more options as to like settings and different things for your video. So I uploaded it here. I gave it a title. I gave it a description. And basically now we've got something that looks just like this. So pretty cool, right? It fills the whole screen. It looks really nice. You know, it's this whole screen effect here. And this will be totally cool for any kind of explainer video or just some little advertisement or just, you know, a fun way for me to engage with the fans of Media Resonate through quick little animations like this. So pretty awesome. I'm actually hoping to get some kind of live streaming going with this as well, because that would be really cool if somehow we could jigger that whole thing together to do a live stream on Instagram. That's about it. Once it's up there, you can go ahead and share it with the world and show everybody how awesome you are. So if you didn't know, I do have an Instagram account. It's Media Resonate on Instagram, and I tend to post lots of pictures, concept art, and different things that I'm doing for the different projects I'm working on. So feel free to check that out. And if you didn't know, I'm creating a animated series, but I did enlist some friends, and they're helping me out with writing and just coming up with ideas and different things like that. I'm still doing all the art myself, unfortunately, but I'm hoping if this takes off, we can get some more people involved in it and make it a little bit bigger of a thing. All right, so stick around. If you haven't subscribed, please hit that button. The series is coming up. I think you're all really gonna dig it, and I hope you found this information on Instagram useful and use it to make something cool. All right, until next time.